All right, on this Inside Line, we're catching up with the Rock Ballerina and going to learn about how 50,000 miles and stock axles is working out on 40s 2 years later.
Let's see, from the last go around upgrades, as anyone would expect, I've upgraded ball joints. The factory ones, they're a little lackluster. They don't kind of they don't handle stock tires, let alone 40 inch tires. So you start putting a high offset wheel on it and really getting that scrub radius jacked up, and it really starts wearing things out. From there, I went with the upgraded Danas, which were better than the factory ones, but they didn't last all that long. So just recently, 40,000 miles, I put the Dynatrax in. Immediate difference in the way it tracked down the road, immediate difference in the stiffness of the steering, which was perfect. That was what I wanted. And oddly enough, steering has probably been the biggest aspect of this build that has seen the most upgrades since the last time we met. Jeep themselves came up with some upgrades. We've got the new cast iron knuckles off of the Mojave on this thing, and little known fact, the diesels come standard with the cast iron knuckles. But cast iron knuckles, we got the new upgraded cast iron steering box, which was a noticeable difference as well. And then just to kind of take it one step further and make sure that the steering would always be dialed in, I put that Synergy steering box brace on it. Those are probably that and shocks have been the biggest, probably most noticeable upgrade. I went with that SDI eClick Pro system just to really try it out. And their motto is like, no compromises for right. The terrain. And they really live up to it. Like, it's not snake oil. It's one of those things that, like, unless you've experienced it,
right,
it's really hard to tell. But it's kind of like that first time someone messed with a UTV that had dynamic ride control, and you just hit a button and it's right. Smooth now, or you hit a button and it's sporty and race mode and stiff in the corners, and it is night and day different. And to be able to sit there and really tailor it to what your comfort level is pretty slick.
Now, for those that aren't familiar with the basics of the build, 2 years ago, caught up with Cooper and what he delightfully called the Rock Ballerina. Yeah. And essentially, it's a Rubicon, or that's what it started out. Mm-hmm. Life is basically a Rubicon. So it's got the turbo 2 liter in it.
Yep.
Automatic 8-speed. Mm-hmm. Still stock axles, and it's on 40s. Now, mm-hmm. Typically, we'll say Cooper's not clueless. He knows that usually with his driving, the 40s and are going to require some big axles. And yes, there is a giant JT Gladiator with a Hellcat and
oh, yeah.
a Pro Rock 60 front
proper
and an 80
axles.
Rear. Yeah.
Yeah.
So this isn't like, I don't know any better. This is like, let's just test and see kind of how we can go. So, and now inside, it's still factory lockers, right? And 538
yep.
gears?
Factory electric lockers, 538 gears. The upgrades that I did to try and make everything last longer were, I went with a set of RCVs in the front and did that fad delete axle shaft.
Okay.
So it gets rid of that little intersection there, we'll call it,
yet.
The teeny
yeah,
tiny
yeah.
with the massive splines,
right.
Like, it's so
yeah,
funny, you
yeah.
get the fine splines on the outside, but those right. splines are like, yeah, well, good luck.
Yep.
And then out back did the upgraded chromoly shafts, so, and really, I swapped those out, and I was blown away at how big those axle shafts are anyway. They're huge.
Right.
Like, they're no slouch, so that was kind of confidence inspiring, and then to have them upgraded to chromoly. I haven't had any issues with axle shafts. I haven't had any issues with housings. Now, to kind of get back to what you were saying there, yes, I am well aware that this is not the right combination of things. And this little 2 liter turbo, despite only being 2 liters, is cuckoo for power. Like, it has no problem torching these 40 inch tires. And I thoroughly believed when I first built this that I was on borrowed time with axle shafts,
sure.
like ready to order big boy axles. But I find that the driving style that I take now, because I know that, is a lot more thought out, we'll say.
Right.
It's less rock bouncer, less, I'm just going to go here and it's going to be fine, and more methodical of where am I going to put my tires? How am I going to do this? Am I going to ease into it and crawl it first and see how it does? And,
right.
And then assess whether I need to turn lockers off and bump it. And I spend a lot of time paying attention to lockers. Lockers right. on, lockers off. What's the wheel speed doing and where I'm at? And so that aspect of it has
That's
actually
part of the
been...
The key for survival yeah. for this is really knowing how to drive it and where to drive it. Now, you've been on the same 40-inch trail grapplers and beadlocks basically the entire time.
Just about the whole time. Well, I started off with stickies.
Right.
And I wiped those out really right. fast, as you would expect with sticky. So then I thought, you know, I'm going to give the street compound a go. And I spend a lot of time in the snow and ice, so I've, you know, messed around with them a little bit as far as siping and playing with that. But, yeah, these tires so far, these ones have, like, 35,000 miles on them.
Wow.
And I'm, like, totally blown away at getting 35,000 miles out of a 40-inch tire.
Yeah, that's unique in general.
Yeah.
Now, any other mods? Now, I think we talked about a little bit last time, you had the sort of regular fender delete to allow this thing to run for you. It's still pretty low lift, though.
Yeah.
I know you did a shock upgrade, but you're still on, like, what, a 3-inch or 4-inch coil?
Yeah, 3-inch.
Yeah, so, I mean, that's nothing, you know?
No.
You know, so having the stubby bumper, you did upgrade sliders, and it looks like you've
yes,
used those a few times. What's the story with the sliders?
They are a company called XS Industries. Really nice. Actually, there have been a couple upgrades since then. I've also got a full belly skid plate.
Okay.
Now, and then the rear bumper and rock sliders made by the same company, XS Industries, and they're great. You know, they stick out just enough that I know when I fall into something, the body's not going to get hit.
Right.
And yes, I have used them. They're a key tool when you get used to using them and sliding off of stuff or pivoting around on them. It's really nice to have them. And the last time I had just the factory Rubicon ones, and those weren't going to do anything.
Now,
so.
Well, I'll say one of the things that we get in the YouTube comments, video, so many people asking about fuel economy and does it keep eighth gear? So. Right.
Well, the nice thing is, with the 538s and the power that this thing has, yes, it will keep 8th gear, no problem. As far as fuel mileage goes, if I wanted fuel mileage, I'd have gotten a Prius.
Right.
You know, that's not
true.
What I got, a brick
right.
to drive down the road and put 40s on for.
Sure.
So the measurement for me is more like miles per gallon.
Sure, sure.
And it's through the roof on this. So.
Right, but the actual number is pretty low?
it's not as bad as you would think. It's typically right around 14.
Okay, so that's not crazy. I mean, my Gladiator's usually around 15, 16 with 37, so
right.
I don't have 40s, and you know, so that's not crazy.
If I were to do it all over again, I think I would go 4xE.
That's awesome. I'm excited to see what the 4xE platform
yeah,
and how it comes. I think it's just going to be good for everything. Well, how can people follow and find you and what you guys are doing so they can keep updated on all your crazy
yeah.
builds and see when this thing, if it ever goes any further in one direction or the other?
Right. Well, as always, we got Facebook, Instagram, and then our YouTube channel, and we're continually doing our own videos and productions there. We have a podcast every other week where we sit down and just kind of talk about, you know, the things that we meander across while we're out off-roading and some of the mistakes that we've made. So, I mean, follow along with that. Maybe you'll learn something the easy way at our expense.
That's always better. Well, cool. I appreciate
yeah.
you taking the time. It's cool to see the old Rock Ballerina is back alive and still working. I know there's so many people that want to run 40s and stock axles.
Mm-hmm.
You being brave enough to try out this
right.
is good. I mean, it's neat to see this thing still alive. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to give Off-Road Power Products a like and check out what they're doing. Obviously, if you guys like these videos, please like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. If you have any questions for me, you can always find me at Ollie Mansour Editor on Instagram. And until then, see you next time.
Booyah!